Ladies and gentlemen, Denny Diaz, founding member of Steely Dan. I'm so happy, man, that you called me to get you, man, to be on Mickey's Free Ride, which is on every Saturday on 93.9 The Mountain. I'm so happy, dude, that we could finally connect. We haven't spoken in a while, but this show is just going to be about stuff that you've done, Denny, and your association with, you know, Steely Dan. And I got to tell you right off the bat, bro, that you're solo. You know which one I'm talking about. That sitar solo. Was that a real sitar, Denny?
No, I don't know how to play the sitar. That was a Coral Electric sitar, which is basically a Dan Electro guitar.
That sounded so friggin' cool.
Yeah, it's got a funny bridge that makes it buzz. We rented the thing because we thought we'd put a droning sitar sound on the record, and it didn't drone very well. But it was like a guitar, and I started playing it, and somebody said, why don't we do it solo with that?
Denny, it sounded amazing. When you, you know, started your career and you applied in the Village Voice magazine, I mean, and Donald Fagen and Walter Breck responded to your advertisement, Denny, that was just like crazy. I mean, at that time, of course, I'm sure, you didn't know that you were going to, you know, be joining Skunk Baxter and all that stuff, but that's way down the road, right?
Yeah, I mean, they didn't have much of a name either, you know?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They were just looking for something to do. And I spent about an hour on the phone with Walter, and I told him we weren't sure that we needed a piano player. And he said, once I hear the piano player, we'll probably change our mind.